Yes, so all of your needles for your mass spec syringes should be the blunt tip. You can't be sometimes what you can't see. And so for many students beginning with K through 12, it can be hard for them to even aspire or even think to aspire to be a scientist if they don't have a role model. Hi, I'm Renã Robinson. I am an associate professor of chemistry, and I'm the Dorothy J. Wingfield Phillips Chancellor's Faculty Fellow.
Wingfield Phillips is the first African-American female to earn an undergraduate degree at Vanderbilt.
So it's very special to me that I get to serve in that chair.
And is that's the caffeine?
Yeah, 199.
For us, it's been very important to ensure that we have a diverse group of researchers on our team. And it has made a world of difference in helping to attract and recruit other students from diverse backgrounds to be a part of the work that we're doing.
Yep, you good.
Oh, I love it. I mean, I love when they figure it out, whether it works or not. I love when they can come to a conclusion on their own. I love when they can begin to see new possibilities that they haven't before. It's part of what keeps me going.
Her lab studies brain proteins to find clues around the memory-robbing disease, Alzheimer's.
So Alzheimer's disease is personal for me, and it goes back to when I was in high school. My mom was a caregiver for Alzheimer's patients at the time, and I'm very empathetic to what people are going through because people are suffering, not only the people that have it, but the people that have to care for them.
And why Alzheimer's is more prevalent in African American and Latinx communities.
Specifically with African Americans, they have 2 to 3 times the incidence of Alzheimer's disease.
Robinson's love of science started early.
When I started to see the practical aspects of science, I think that's what really hooked me. So I was a beauty makeup consultant at Sears, of all places, in high school. And at this beauty counter, I really started to develop like a passion for cosmetics. And there's chemistry in cosmetics. And so that to me made a whole world of sense.
She jumped into unique science immersions.
And it was in an environment that was specifically for African-American, Native American, and Hispanic students. And we're a small cohort of students, and we did accelerated math and science the whole summer. And it was fun. It was a lot of fun. But too, I saw the importance of, when I went back home, how many students in my school did not get to have this particular opportunity. And so I've always felt like programs like that have to be replicated and scaled so that it becomes a normal part of every student's learning experience to be exposed to math and science in ways that they can relate with.
Now, as a professor, mentor, and mother, she encourages a love of science in her children and others.
I've been able to go to schools and do outreach with their classes, and just the joy that they have in being able to help lead the demo, you know, with me to their friends is like amazing to see how excited they are about science.
Creating the right formula to balance it all.
You know, there's no time stamp or no limits on living your life with your profession. It's all a matter of how do you make it work. And you can make it work. You just got to figure out what you need and who you need.